We'll go ahead and get started this morning. I am told I have to be out of here by a certain time and that I better stick with it. So that means I better get going. But I appreciate everybody coming out this morning. And I want to particularly thank the county commissioners, Mr. Barfield, Chairman Barfield, and Beth Dawson, and Skip Watkins, and Woody White, Rob Zappel, all those who worked to get this office secured here in the new Hanover County Office Complex, local government complex here. It really, I think, is important for us to have a presence here. Mr. Chairman, we want to work with you and the rest of the county commissioners and your staff very closely. There's some other elected officials here as well. Mayor Sappho, had a good visit with him and his team a few weeks ago. And I see Daryl Mills here representing Wrightsville Beach, and my friend Leanne Price representing Carolina Beach. And I know my good buddy Dean Lambeth, he and I talk all the time. And I can assure everybody here that Curie Beach is well represented by Dean Lambeth. So anyhow, I see a lot of other folks here in the audience that our team has worked with for some time. In particular, I want to note Rex Creech. Rex worked very diligently to help us locate an office here in New Hanover County. And like I said, we're very grateful to have it here at the government complex. You know, constituent service really is everything. And I used to work for a gentleman who prided himself upon having the very best constituent service in the country. And in fact, he did. I learned a lot of good lessons from him, Senator Jesse Helms. And there's folks that loved Helms and hated Helms, but they all agreed on one thing, and that was if you want to get something done, you went to Senator Helms' office. And bottom line there is if you have a problem, that means we have a problem. And that's why I wanted to make sure we had an office here in Wilmington, and really, really grateful to have it here at the local government complex. Our other district offices are going to be in Brunswick County, there at the county courthouse in Bolivia, and then we'll also have one at the Ag Center in Smithfield up in Johnston County. We, in addition to our three primary district offices, we're going to have local office hours in every county in this district. And as you may know, there are 12 counties that comprise this district. Those of us who have campaigned all over this district know there are 12 counties and know just how big this district is. But that, I think, is an indicator of the commitment that we are going to have and currently do have to addressing the needs of all the citizens of the district. I want to introduce some of my staff. Particularly the local staff. Dwight Williams. Dwight, if you'll raise your hand. Dwight is our district director. Dwight is a native of Sampson County, has been employed with the American Farm Bureau and the North Carolina Farm Bureau for about 28 years. He retired December 31 and started on our payroll January the 3rd. And so we're very grateful to have Dwight with us. Dwight also has been on the Sampson County Board of Elections. He was chairman of the Sampson County Republican Party for a long time, and as most of you know, Sampson County has been part of the 7th Congressional District for a good long while. And so Dwight knows this district and the needs of this district quite well. Chance Lambeth, a lot of you know Chance. Chance is our deputy district director, and Chance will be based here on the coast. And in fact, I'm going to be here the vast majority of the time myself. When I'm not in Washington, but Chance is going to be focused on our coastal issues. He is just a great, smart young man, very hard worker, and we're very grateful to have him move over from the campaign team where he served as our political director and will serve as our deputy district director and with a focus on the coastal issues. One other person who is not here this morning but will be joining us in Bolivia that I want to mention is Mary Ellen Simmons. Some of you remember Mary Ellen from her time working with Congressman McIntyre. She ran his district office for a good while, retired a few years back. Mary Ellen was in retirement, and I called her. I said, Mary Ellen, I said, nobody knows coastal issues and the agencies better than you do. Would you mind coming back on a part-time basis at least for 3 or 4 months, and working with Chance directly to make sure that we're covering all the bases and are up to speed, and that Chance has an opportunity to learn your Rolodex as well as you do. And she said absolutely, and Mary Ellen has been a tremendous asset to our team already. That institutional knowledge is absolutely critical, and so I'm very thankful to have Mary Ellen's services as long as she wants to render them. She stressed to me, she said, "David, I'm part-time and only part-time." I said, "I got it." And but anyhow, a part-time Mary Ellen is equivalent to a full-time for most people. As you know, she knows so much and has so many great contacts all throughout this district, particularly among all the various agencies, particularly the Army Corps of Engineers. And I see Dwight up, not Dwight, but I see Darryl up here nodding his head. And we all know how important it is to have those relationships with those government agencies that we have to work with daily. So I want to mention that to you as well. Let me also stress to you that, and I hope the press will report this, you know, our district office, a lot of people are curious, well, what does a district office do? Well, you know, if we have a constituent or anybody, then you don't necessarily have to be in my district or in this district. But if you have a passport issue, or if you have a VA issue or a Social Security issue, Social Security disability, whatever it may be, our district office is comprised of a number of caseworkers. One that we're going to have here full-time in the Wilmington office, Brenda Swartz. Brenda, if you can raise your hand. Brenda is focused on our VA veterans casework. In fact, she is married to a Vietnam veteran, a disabled veteran, and has just an incredible passion for veterans and the issues that they face on a daily basis. And Brenda, I'm very grateful to have you as part of the team, and just so thankful that you're committing your time and your efforts. And I have heard nothing but great things about Brenda all the way up in Washington, D.C. I have people call me and say, I love Brenda Swartz. And I said, well, good, I do too. And so, Brenda, we're really, really grateful to have you here. She will be in this office, you know, full time. Right here. So any issues that you have, you'll see Brenda's smiling face when you walk through that door. Couple things I want to mention. One is obviously when I got elected, I made several commitments. One was that I would do my very best to address the local needs of the area. Because of that, and given the nature of the local needs that we have, the Transportation and Infrastructure Committee and the Agriculture Committee were the two primary committees that I worked really hard to get on. A lot of people don't realize that after you win an election, you have to go start another campaign. And that second campaign was basically campaigning to get the committee assignments that you want, because you don't just get them. You have to go and campaign and lobby for them. And your colleagues take a look at which committees you want to serve on, and then they vote. And so it's a whole different kind of campaign, so to speak. And I think I was probably the only freshman that got my number one and number two choices. And so we were very, very fortunate. The Transportation and Infrastructure Committee is obviously very critical. That's the committee that has jurisdiction over the Army Corps of Engineers. We've got a couple major pieces of legislation coming up this year, the FAA reauthorization bill, and we have the highway reauthorization bill, which we'll be working on late in the spring. Highway reauthorization bill is obviously critical. The details of that are inherent in the name. I've got I-95 and I-40 that cut through the middle of the district, and it will also serve as a vehicle where I hope to be able to take care of some of the regulatory issues that are cumbersome, you know, for our local governments and our mayors in particular, and particularly as it relates to our beaches issues. There's going to be probably work on a water resources bill, not this year, but probably going into next year. And those of you who are well-versed in coastal issues are quite familiar with what they call the Water Bill. And so we'll have another one of those bills coming up here in the next year and a half or so, and that'll be another vehicle that we take a look at to try to address some of the specific needs of the area. From a macro standpoint, I think you're going to see the House of Representatives pass a lot of really good legislation, at least in my viewpoint. And last week we passed the Keystone Pipeline authorization, and that's in the Senate. The Senate will deal with it over the next 2 to 3 weeks. My chief of staff, who's spent her entire working career on the House side, said, "Do you think they'll get that done in a few days?" I said, no, Melissa. I said, "That'll be like 3 weeks." The Senate is a very different body than the House. When the House decides it's going to do something, it can act fairly quickly. The Senate is a very different beast, and it takes a lot longer to get anything through the Senate. Plus, you have to have a supermajority vote even to move forward on legislation. But I anticipate the Keystone Pipeline legislation will get through the Senate, and we'll see what the president does. There'll be other pieces of legislation, including tax reform. I think you'll see come out of the House, and we'll see what kind of version they can get out of the Senate. But I think you're going to see a major effort to reduce the rates and broaden the base and make it simpler, flatter, and fair is a good way to put it. And so we'll see what happens there. But I'm know for certain we'll have some version of tax reform come out of the House. On the immigration issue, we have a border security bill on the floor this week, and that deals just strictly with border security and makes some important steps to improve our border security. And then subsequent to that legislation, I think you'll see us come forward with a new worker visa program that streamlines that process so that our employers can get the workers they need when they need them. Anybody who's in business can tell you what a nightmare it is to get employees in the country legally. Sometimes it takes a year, 2 years through the visa process, and our farmers can certainly tell you how cumbersome it is to try to get agriculture workers. And I think what you'll see out of the House is incremental pieces of legislation that deal with the immigration issue step by step. I can't speak for what will happen in the Senate on that front. But those are some of the major issues here in the first 6 months. In addition to the highway reauthorization bill, the FAA reauthorization bill, in the Ag Committee, which I was also appointed to, they named me chairman of the Livestock and Foreign Agriculture Service, Foreign Agriculture Programs, and that actually was a real shocker to me. It's exceptionally rare for a freshman to be a chairman of a subcommittee. And on the Ag Committee in particular, particularly the last 40 or 50 years, nobody knows of a freshman that's ever chaired a subcommittee. On the Ag Committee, it's almost unheard of. And when they offered me the gavel, I said, "Well, I'm not dumb enough to say no. I'll say yes." But that's certainly not anything that I lobbied for and was really caught by surprise. But serving as chairman of the Livestock and Foreign Agriculture is going to be a big help to me to help this district. Agriculture is a huge component to this district. We have a lot of livestock, obviously in Sampson, Duplin counties in particular. But that chairmanship is going to afford us an opportunity, give us a little extra leverage to do some other good things. And so I'm very grateful, very, very honored, very humbled to have the opportunity to serve in the capacity that I am. We will do everything to the very best of our ability to address the needs of this area and Wilmington and New Hanover County specifically, and certainly our beach communities. I want to also recognize Sheriff, our good sheriff here in New Hanover County, Ed. Appreciate you coming out here this morning. And there may be some others in the audience that I have missed who are local elected officials, and I apologize if I have. But I just really appreciate all of you and look forward to working with you in every way that I can. I know, Tyler, we have several interviews lined up with press individually after this, but I'd be happy to take a question or two if somebody has one. Yes, sir.
Yeah, you mentioned border security. Is there anything specific on the bill that's coming forward that you can tell us more specifics about what you said about border security?
Sure. Well, it includes funding for more fencing. It includes, and this is coming out of the Homeland Security Committee. And so the bill was tailored to the specific jurisdictional restraints of that committee. So it deals only with border security. It doesn't deal with anything inside our borders. It just literally deals with what's on the border. So we're talking about funding for more personnel, technological advances, equipment, and fencing in particular. Those are the highlights. Well, with that, I want to, again, thank you for coming. The office is right across the hall here. I hope you'll take an opportunity and go over and check it out. Again, Brenda, raise your hand so everybody knows who you are. Brenda Swartz is going to be the smiling face that you'll see there every day. Chance Lambeth will also be working in it, working in and out of the Wilmington office here. And so anything that you need or any concerns that you have, feel free to pop by the office. And, of course, you're always welcome to call Washington as well. And there's a young lady by the name of Perry Chappell. Perry is a Wilmington native, and she answers the phone when you call the Washington office, and we're very grateful to have Perry on board. We also have a couple of UNCW graduates that are working in our Washington office, and so we're real pleased to have the team that we have assembled. I think you'll be very very pleased, and certainly you know, any issue that you have, don't hesitate to let us know, you know, what we can do to be helpful. And I think you'll be pleased with the team that we've assembled as well. So thank you, and Tyler, I guess we'll line up the individual press interviews as scheduled. Thank you very much. Appreciate you coming.